Hello children, today we will take up lesson 3 of grammar, subject and predicate. So far we have done what a sentence is and what are its kind. Children, any kind of sentence, be it a statement, an imperative, an exclamatory, or an interrogative sentence. All these sentences can be divided into two parts, namely subject and predicate. Focus on the examples given under the heading A. Ritu lives in a big house. A big oak tree stood in a corner of the yard. Here one part of the sentence names somebody or something, and the other part of the sentence gives additional information about that somebody or something. So with this comes two basic parts of a sentence, subject and predicate. Focus on the part written in red. The part of the sentence which names what the sentence is about is the subject. In simple words, the part of the sentence that tells you what you are talking about, that part of the sentence makes the subject of that sentence. The second heading in red, the part of the sentence which says something about the subject is the predicate. In simple words, the information in a sentence about the subject is known as predicate. Let's come back to the examples once again. Ritu lives in a big house. Here Ritu is the word or is the person or is the name we are talking about. And lives in a big house gives additional information about Ritu. In a similar manner, a big oak tree stood in a corner of the yard. The first part of the sentence names the thing we are talking about. And the other part of the sentence gives information about that big oak tree. So that part becomes the predicate. Now this subject, children, may consist of only one word, as was in the case of sentence number 1, which read, Ritu lives in a big house. But the same subject can be of more than one word, as in the case of second sentence, which read, a big oak tree, which comprises of 4 words, a, big, oak, and tree. So a subject can be of one word, or it may consist of a group of words. Now comes the position of the subject. Children, the subject can be placed anywhere in the sentence. I have written there in pencil position of the subject. Please write all the headings or all the important points which I have written in pencil in your book as well. Now, usually the subject comes in the beginning of the sentence, but it is the case which I said usually, not always. And that is how I have put number 1 and 2 for the subject position. The first one reads, the subject is usually placed in the beginning of the sentence. See, I have circled the word usually. Take care of this. It's written usually. Means it is not always the case. Once again, the subject is usually placed in the beginning of the sentence. But this does not mean that any word in the beginning of the sentence will be naming the subject. That may not be the case. Look at the example given below. At the bottom of the river lay his eggs. Lay his eggs. So in this case, as you can notice that we are talking about eggs, but this word is not placed in the beginning of the sentence. So the subject of this sentence is his eggs, but the subject is placed at the end. To make rule number 2, you please make the changes in the sentence which is printed, but the subject is also placed at the end. Please make it as rule number 2. So the first rule you will read is the subject is usually placed in the beginning of the sentence, and the second rule to this position of the subject is the subject is also placed at the end. Read it as a rule, not a explanation to what is written before that. Let's move ahead. Subject in an imperative sentence. Now children, it is very easy to locate a subject in an in a statement, in a negative sentence, in an exclamatory sentence. But it gets a little bit tricky to find out the subject for interrogatives specially. First, look into this subject in an imperative sentence. Then with the exercise questions, I'll explain you how to locate a subject for an interrogative sentence. Look at this sentence, brush your teeth. Likewise, I can put number of sentences like this, which are commanding or imperative in nature. Sit, stand up, get out. Open your book. These all sentences are imperatives. In imperative sentences, children, the subject is usually missing. And we take you as the subject of an imperative sentence. See, as it is written here, this sentence actually means you should brush your teeth. Actually, when you give a command, when you request something, or it's an advice, or you give an order, it is somebody who's taking that order. But that somebody is not implied. Implied means it is not specifically mentioned there. So, you is taken as the subject of imperative sentences. See, there are many other sentences, imperative sentences written here. Stand up, wait outside. All these mean you should stand up and you may wait outside. So that is how the subject of an imperative sentence is always you. As I said, whatever important points have been marked in the video with the pencil, you need to mark them in your book. Now, I was talking about what is not mentioned in your book. Please listen to it carefully. Sometimes you get stuck up when you don't, or you can say when you are unable to locate a subject, especially in an interrogative sentence. In that case, children, try to make the interrogative sentence, that is a question, into a simple statement. For example, question number 9 in your exercise for D question, part 9, who brought these beautiful flowers? Now convert it into a statement. These beautiful flowers were brought by my mother. Now what comes in the beginning, or what is the thing that you are talking about? It is these beautiful flowers. So the subject of this interrogative sentence will be these beautiful flowers. And whatever is left will be the predicate. I hope you got it. Only one question is given there in your exercise. The rest will be shared with you in the form of PDF for practice. So you may write somewhere in your book that if the sentence is interrogative, change the sentence into statement. In simple words, give answer to that question. And then look for the thing or person you are talking about. Whatever comes as the main part or the noun you are talking about, that will form the subject of an interrogative sentence. Sometimes it so happens in exclamatory sentences also. It becomes a little bit difficult to locate the sentence. Again, change it into a simple statement and focus on what you are talking about, and the focused part will be your subject, and the rest of the words in that sentence will be the predicate. I hope you understood. That's all for the day. Thank you. Have a nice day.